was just like a, oh, this is such a lovely little moment. I'll just share it with my brothers and I'll put it on Facebook. Why not?
I was certainly pleased that she did that. Not necessarily for the publicity or notoriety.
He was like, oh, you just put an old man with a computer and it's gonna go viral.
Here's an old guy and he still enjoys teaching and he hopes that his students are enjoying it almost as much as he is. By reading books, we recognize our humanity in those characters and become, I think, if not better human beings, certainly more enlightened human beings. Great literature teaches us what it means to be human.
Tell you about my dad. There's so much to tell about my dad.
My name is Charles Crone.
He's 91.
Professor Emeritus of English Literature at the University of St. Thomas.
He's been a resident company actor at the Alley for 55 years, I think.
I've been teaching here since 1966, about 54 years. I'm very fortunate because I retired officially from the university this last spring, and now I'm in an emeritus status where I'm teaching a couple of courses 5 days a week.
They're gonna have to drag him out of there kicking and screaming.
Yeah.
I was in class on a Thursday sometime in about the middle of March, and right after class somebody came in and said, okay, they're shutting the school down, and so on. Oh, okay. So we had to shift to an online status the very next week. That shift has not been easy.
Like any of these teachers, the learning curve was steep. But also, like he does with anything, it was so like, well, okay, I guess that's what we're doing. I was sitting there making sure the computer was working, making sure he was looking at the camera, because he has a tendency to, because he's so in it. I have to get a picture of this, I have to take a video.
It was absolutely unexpected.
Just blew up. He is so soft-spoken and so humble, and so he's not going to be, effusive with, oh, this is amazing, I'm so, it's very quiet.
Well, it's like anything, if you do something in private or something, and you say, what? You were taking, oh, I wish I had done this or done that, or was my hair in place,
I know that it touches him so deeply.
If there is something, that comes out of that that sneaky daughter of mine taking that film of my teaching in a virtual situation, to what extent it might inspire some others, both students and teachers, to say, well, hey, this isn't necessarily a bad thing to do. That is, human beings getting together and talking about great literature.
For him to not only be 91 and still teaching, to be teaching as well as he's teaching, to be taking it in stride the way he is, and being 91 and being just as passionate, if not more so, than he was 50 years ago.
I have never once wished I wasn't doing what I was doing. Maybe some of my students have wished that, but I have never wished that. So for me, I would like to continue as long as I can.
He can only exist if he's doing. So, I mean, this, I think, is partly why he's still teaching at 91 and doesn't look 91, doesn't act 91, because he's doing what he loves.